fight against corruption begins with me. The fight against corruption begins with you. And you. And you.
Together, against corruption.
Named Dona Kostoranova, organization Youth Educational Forum, country Macedonia. It started as an initiative by a group of people supported by WBI who didn't even know each other and worked together virtually through video conferences, through emails, through all sorts of communication to start this network. And then we had our first forum, which was organized in Brussels, where a group of activists from several countries around the world met together, worked and exchanged tools.
We have an opportunity to bring in fresh and new ideas.
How can a country say it is fighting corruption if its next generation is being educated by corrupted people? So for me, the best way to fight against corruption is to be a role model for the next generation.
We need to have youth that's not afraid to speak up, and what we're trying to do is raise awareness and skill for locating problems in their community and giving them methods of action.
This initiative continued to grow, resulting in a second additional forum in Nairobi, where over 60 people from over 40 countries, if I'm not mistaken, took participation and worked on the various tools we can use all in our respective countries. That's when this network even became official. It had a structure, it voted its coordinative body, and from that moment on we've been working really hard and advancing.
Hello, I'm Marlon from the Philippines. I'm with the SK Reform Coalition. In the country, we work with young people to get them involved in governance work, because governance work in the country is not so popular among young people. So we introduce governance and social accountability in creative, artistic, and using ICT to get young people involved. Through the GIAC network, we were able to establish relationship. And when I say relationship, it's partnership. Across the different regions. I'm coming from Asia and the Pacific, from the Philippines, and we have worked with our colleagues, with young people, youth organizations in Latin America, particularly in Peru and in Paraguay. We share experiences.
Hello, my name is Emmanuel Callejas. I come from Guatemala. Something that we've collaborated with in the region is the sharing of information. This has definitely become one of the most important pillars of work that we've done. Many of the groups involved in the anti-corruption fight are keen to produce reports in order to share good practices, better practices, present results, and also present some of the weaknesses in the plans that they execute.
I'm Laurent Gabiwambo. I'm from Cameroon. With our fellow from Nigeria, we are sharing experience to how to promote corrupt-free youth business and entrepreneurship, and we are gaining more from them to try to promote the same thing in Cameroon so that our country should be free of corruption.
They are also using ICT, and we are also using ICT in the region, and together we are comparing the tools that we are using, and we are, in this comparison, we are able to level up our innovations.
Collaboration is very important. We can do something without collaboration, but it won't be effective and efficient in the result as when you are working in collaboration with another youth and you are gaining experience from him, and you enrich what you have to do in your country.
It's absolutely incredible to see all these guys really excited to fight corruption. It's a great cause, and the tools that the World Bank Institute is giving us and the participants over here is invaluable tools that they can use and that they can teach other youth to combat corruption actively.
Yeah, I don't speak Arabic, he doesn't speak English, but somehow, it kind of just works. So the message comes across, so it's all right, yeah.
I believe that musicians also have an important role because they have the capacity to really outreach the people through their music, to reach listeners, to reach the youth and engage them in the subject of corruption and become not only musicians as entertainers, but I would say leaders of their communities and of our society.
We can do everything, starting from music and culture, to creative activism, to online activism, to policy making. The goal is to have as many young people aware about this, knowing that their voice can be heard.
I believe this could not have been achieved if we hadn't held on to the network so tightly. We have been able to implement plans to the future. We have been able to recognize that we hold a common ground and we have a common purpose to fight on.
And this is the start of making a constituency of young people that would be advocating for good governance and fighting corruption in their country. And this is done because there is this network called Global Youth Anti-Corruption Network, where we can come together, we can talk, we can share experiences, we can share lessons and problems, and we can solve them together.
What has been successful about it is keeping in touch, producing, reporting.
Our different initiatives are being leveled up. We are trying to innovate on our innovation to do more and to be more efficient.
Against corruption. Together against corruption. Together against corruption.